getting y'all out of jails, out of the city. Go ahead and let them know what jail we're gonna drop.
What's up, y'all? It's T.B TIARRA, and I'm an upcoming artist from Mobile, Alabama.
Alright, T.B. Tell the folks where you from.
I'm from Prichard, but they're located in Mobile, so it's just like a little small little city, but overall Alabama.
So you're originally from Prichard?
Yep.
What the T.B. stand for?
Everybody wanna know that. I don't know. I mean, I just, over time, I made it stand for that bitch, but I don't really want to say that because I don't want to seem too cocky, but I just, like, coming up with the name, I was just thinking about other artists, like, Megan, she'll stay, you see the girl, they from the city, like, what you think of yourself, and I feel like on that bitch, you feel me? So I just said T.B. for short.
Alright. Well, you grew up in a single-parent household, or a two-parent household?
Two-parent.
Two-parent household?
Yeah.
So you're a privileged child?
You can say that, yeah, to be from Prichard.
Hello, you don't stay in prison no more. You seen the election? What you thought about the election?
I just felt like no matter who we elect, I mean, Prichard's still gonna be Prichard. Like, I just feel like the most important thing, like when I really see change, is when the streets and shit start getting fixed. Like, it's change. Everybody want that fixed.
All right, what high school you went to?
I went to Viagra.
You went to Viagra? You was a cheerleader or what?
I was a cheerleader and a flag girl.
And a flag girl. Yep. They both on.
Flag.
Yeah, everybody say that, but it's not bad. And plus my line, that year wouldn't even like be girls, but everybody be like, you was a flag girl. Yeah, it wouldn't even. I just got tired of cheering on you.
All right, so you were popular. You said you were tired of cheering?
Yeah.
You want to try something new?
Yeah. I did everything. I tried out for dance, but I didn't make it.
So that means you can't dance.
I can't dance.
It's a long little for you to dance, no video.
Yeah, I can't dance.
So you was a flag girl. That was a senior?
That was my 10th grade year.
The 10th grade year?
Yep.
So you were popular in high school?
Yep. You can say that.
So that what made your music career be bigger now? Because you already were popular in school?
I feel like that. Plus, just like me being like the area we in, like Mobile small, and then just like I feel like I'm a pretty girl. Like, if you're a pretty girl in Mobile, people gonna kind of know more of you. And then just like.
So, you probably from being pretty?
No, I'm just saying, like, I ain't just trying to say that. It's all off it. But you know what I'm saying? Like, being pretty or a fine girl in Mobile ain't too many of this. So, you feel me? Like, when you are one of them, then like you get noticed more than others. That's how I feel, regardless of what other people say. That's just how I look at it.
So you're a pretty rapper, that's what you're saying?
I like to think so.
before you did the rapping, you sold clothes.
Yeah, I sold clothes.
You still sell clothes?
I'm kind of getting back into it. I stopped for a little bit because I just felt like it wasn't as original, and like I really felt like I was just going too fast, but people fuck with it. So now I'm just trying to revamp and like get more professional with it. Like when I look at Two Longs and you know Giovanni and them, I'm like they hard with it. Like I want to be a hard girl in the city with it.
So you gonna manage your rap career and your clothing line?
Yeah, I think it's possible because I don't want to clock into nobody's job. So, you know, until rap pick up, they're just gonna be like what I do.
Now, how long you been rapping?
I've been rapping since I was little, really, but like I used to always jot stuff down and like read it and be like, nah, this shit weak. And I'd throw it away and shit like that. And then like one day, I was just asking my brother started rapping. And I hear him in his room listening to beat, shit like that. And one day I just let him hear some. Well, one day he didn't even hear my rapping at first. He just came in my room like, bro, you should start rapping. So I don't know if he heard me like in my room one day or what. And I'm like, man, get the fuck out of my room. Like, just chill, like, leave me alone. So over time, I just making songs here and there. And I just let other people hear it and it just started picking up. So I was like, maybe I do need to do this.
The first time I seen you, you was on the live, was late. How that came about, like?
Well, the first time I called like a lot of my homeboys and friends, and I was like, man, I really want to start rapping. I was like, I'm gonna post, I was like, I got something wrote up, you feel me? I was like, but it's to Lil Baby. I was like, I don't know how people gonna feel about that because people look at Lil Baby like a goat, you feel me? If you try to remix or write a song to goat songs, like, they like, oh, you can't do that. Like, whoa, you pushing it. You feel me? So I was like, I'm doing, I'm seeing people fuck with me. I did, my shit went up like the same day. And I was like, I'm just gonna keep doing it. People were writing and writing me, and then that was Young and Let came about. Like, Young used to always share my videos, or he'll DM me like, you hard, so you hard, like, keep pushing, I fuck with you. So I just kept pushing and shit, and then one day, I was like, I was just trying to get everything done myself, like, I was trying to really, like, push it. So it was just getting overwhelming. I ain't know about nothing, like, DistroKid, like, Apple News, all this, so I was just, like, trying to ask other people, but I was like, shit, why not ask Let when I know him personally, and he really, like, pushing it, like, really going hard. So I hit him up. And he, I seen him a couple songs, he was like, you like that, like, come to the studio tonight. And she went to the studio, fucked around with Gino and some other little people, and we just, I just came by MGM, that's how it went.
So you
MGM?
Yeah.
So what the first song you did in the studio?
The first song I did in the studio was Silent. My shit. He ain't picking up his shit, so I'm finna call again. Said I seen him with a bitch and she look like my friend. Thoughts running through my head, I need a master plan. I done been too solid, I ain't giving out no another chance. He thought it was rap cap when I told him that it's time up. I done curved 100 niggas, spin the block and y'all. But the crazy thing is that song been wrote like a year ago.
So what is it about put it out?
I just wrote it on some hurt, mad type time. Like the only part that was like recently, like I finished the end part and it was just like, I'd say probably like four, five lines. But overall that song was written like a year ago.
So you write a lot of your rap now?
Yeah, that's the only thing I really feel comfortable doing. Like when I get in the studio, I'm the type of person will rap get expensive anyway, but I mean, like, I don't really have to pay for studio time no more. But when I did, I used to try to have my shit written down before I go, just so when I know, like, I'm in there, I'm really like having progress. So I write, I don't really freestyle.
You don't
punch in? I punch in sometimes. Like, when I went to the studio with Gino and Let know, I'm like, I'm nervous. I'm like, I'm gonna go to the studio. Like, I've been in Gino's studio before, but it's just like, you know, Gino supposed to be like the gold of the city, so he recording you, you feel like, man, like, I need to already have some hard shit coming in. So when I was in, I was just nervous, but, you know, the song still came together.
You feel like you second-guess yourself a lot?
A lot.
Why is that?
I don't know. I'm just very, I feel like I'm a perfectionist, but also, like, I just like for everything to be perfect. Like, my pictures got to be perfect. My hair, my makeup, everything got to be perfect. And if I don't like it, I'm just going to either delete it or just come right out and just say I don't like it.
So how long did it take for TB to get ready to go somewhere?
Not long if you give her a little head of time. Like, you got to let me know ahead of time because I fall back real quick.
So you got a song coming with that or what?
Yeah, we got a song and a video coming. It's we ain't named it yet, but it's hard. Yeah.
When can we expect that?
I was just talking to him about that last night, so I say at least by November.
By November.
Yeah.
All right. So you had that what a diary of mail.
Keep your eyes on.
It's the diary of a mad black woman. Nigga asked me for some pussy. I said I ain't have it on me.
Keep your eyes on.
I guess real don't recognize real, but shit, that's my fault. Nigga called me broke, I think his phone off. Sedita bitch, laid up in the loft. I'ma make it to the top and that's at any cost. I just might pull up on his ass and take the doors off.
Diary of a Mad Black Woman.
So why you took that down?
It was just causing a lot of tension, like, between me and person who was about me. I mean, I don't really, that ain't even my solely, that ain't even reason, the main reason, but it just like, I put it out there, and I have to understand as an artist, like, you really like putting your life into your music. So when I did it, like, I was thinking on the art side time, when it was out there, I was like, people in my business, like, everybody knowing, like, they hear everything I'm saying in this song, like.
So for the people that didn't get to catch it before you took it down, what the song was about?
It was just basically about me and, like, an ex, and basically how, like, what I go through with him. Like, just basically just being, because, like, I wrote that song in, like, 10 minutes. Like, I was just writing, like, bet, so fast, like, and it just came out.
So you been in your music a lot, like,
yep.
your rap real.
I know that what I was definitely asking you about that freestyle. Because I was listening to the freestyle, you talked about a bad relationship, you selling clothes. Yeah. So all that was real.
Yeah, all that real. Like, like real deal, my friend with my new type shit.
What you made a song about?
What style you categorize yourself in? Like, you a city girl type rapper? Like,
see, that's the thing. Like, I'm not a city girl type rapper, but I feel like I'm a city girl in real life. Like, I feel like I'm a city girl.
Why you say that?
Because, like, you gotta cut the check. Like, you just got to. Like, everything the city girls live by, like, I live by that. But also, I live by, like, nigga type shit, too. So it's just like, I'm just like a mix of everything.
All right, so what the people can expect when you gonna drop an album?
I'm working on that now. That's what I'm doing. Like, I'm just trying to, like, stay active on my page and shit like that. But overall, I'm just really just working on, like, having a lot of songs. Because that's the problem. Like, I don't really know how to make songs. Like, I feel like I just always freestyle on the beat. Like, I'll just keep going. So I'm just trying to make me some songs, you feel me, so I can get an album. But I say at least fit my album by December. It ain't gonna take that long. Not really. The first one, I'm gonna drop an EP probably first. But then after that, I'm gonna have some features. I really just wanna do, you know, I got a song with Lita already. I wanna do a song with Honeycomb, but you know, like, he don't even know about me yet or nothing like that either way, but he hard to me. And like somebody like Be Able or some shit like that.
So you gonna use that song
with
Lita as your coming out song?
I don't know yet.
But your album, like, to promote your album and EP?
Yeah, I think so. I think that's what we're going to, like, end up doing, but I ain't really for sure yet. We still just going with the flow right now.
So what are you going to do when you start performing? You can't really laugh at
that. That's what I said. Like, and then, like, I'm kind of, you know, you really need to wear heels, but I'm kind of like, ooh, that's a little nerves. I might fall, anything like that, but I don't know. I'm just... Even in the club on a regular day, like, I'm on some, like, bop in my head, like, on the homeboy type time. So when I get on the stage, I don't know what I'm gonna do. Like, I can't twerk, like, I can't do nothing.
So you ain't performed yet?
No, I ain't performed yet. I think what I need is my people behind me. Everybody just gotta be behind me, saying my shit, hyping me up, and I'm gonna be good.
we always ask the artists to give us three artists that we want to do a song with out the city. Give us three that you want to do a song with out of our city. I ain't talking about Cap, and yeah. I ain't talking about Rollo or
Blue. And you can't say Lit, because you...
you can't say Lit either, because you already MGM track, like...
Well, I have to say Samiria, which we already on that tip or whatever. But Samiria, definitely going to have to be Zay Hardaway.
Shout out to Zay.
And I say...
I knew you were going to say that.
I love you. I listen a lot.
Those three artists out of the industry you want to do a song with?
I say out the industry, you definitely know I got to say Lil Baby. But before Lil Baby, Bad was my, you know. Like, so I say Bad Baby. And, oh, never, I'm going to change that. Because I forgot, like, I got to put the girls in there. But I definitely, man, if I can do a song with Gotti, bro, that would be too hard. Like, I love Gotti. But Gotti, I have to say Mulatto, and Lil Baby, I'm gonna keep Baby now. Or Kodak. Yeah, he hard.
Yeah, you like nothing but, ain't listening to any R&B and little something?
I like Dirt. I like Blue. Yeah. But overall, I ain't that type of girl. Like,
you like to keep it guys?
Yeah, overall.
What's the name of that song that you got the little troll video to that I posted?
Oh, that was a feature with a dude named Lil Poppy, but that was a little trill I did, a little feature I did on that.
I love me a trap nigga. Beat it from the back to my rap nigga. Finesse him out of cash like bap nigga. Just to put his head in my lap nigga. Hold on, hold on. Let me pop my shit. Walk around, head out, you got some new dick. Animated nigga, put some ice on my wrist.
Appreciate it. We working on that now.
Yeah, I talked to him. He said y'all finna get ready to pick that up.
Yeah, he said it.
And, so who inspired, what female, do a female artist inspire you?
I've been following Mulatto for a minute. Like, she inspired me.
She signed with Gucci Mane?
Yeah, she just signed with him. But she been doing a lot on her own, like, for years. What I deal, you feel me? So that really, like, inspired me. I just want to do everything without a deal first. Like, I don't want to drop a chain without a deal. I want to do everything without a deal. So then when I do get a deal, you know you can't lowball me. Like, you got to come with it.
So let your motivation, like, do he motivate you? Like,
yeah.
Like, we being under him, you know what I'm saying? See what he doing.
Yeah, like, yesterday, I was just walking in the mall. I hadn't seen him or talked to him about, I'd say, a couple days or a week. I seen it. He already told me chain was on the way. I seen that shit dancing. I'm like, oh, they lit. I'm like, yeah, that hard. Yeah, I gotta get that.
All right. So you just started. So what you want the fan to remember you as?
I just want them, everybody to remember me as
T.B.
Like, I really live my raps, like, and I really just don't do nothing for clout, none of that type of shit. Like, it's just really, I just be me. And I just want everybody to continue fucking with me, like, all my supporters. Like, it's a lot of y'all already. Like, I appreciate that.
You know how, like, some artists sign under their favorite artist, like, you
yeah.
Know? Artist that you assign, like,
Gucci
Mane or something like that?
Yeah, I already said that, like, you know how, like, Baby got artists too?
Yeah.
Like, I had said that, like, I'm like, if it get to the point where, you feel me, Lit get big and he wanna sign me, like, I might sign with Lit, or if it get to the point where somebody wanna sign me on, like, Gucci Mane, I'll do that too. But I ain't really just even been thinking on no deal right now. I just feel like I got a lot of work to do before I can even just even ask for nobody for a feature or anything. Like, I just feel like I gotta come and have me something, like, show them, like, I'm like that. Like, you can do a feature with me.
How you feel about paying for features inside the city, like, with local rappers? How you feel about
that? I don't really like that. Like, I ain't fucking with that. But I understand, like, everybody gotta do their little own little, you know, thing. Everybody trying to eat too, but I had a couple people write me when I tell them, like, my future price, like, they don't hit back, or they be like, I'm gonna get back with you. But I feel like I'm worth it, you feel me? So, I charge $500. But I used to charge
$250.
But I got some insight on, before I even just said I'm gonna charge $500, I had got some insight on it, you feel me? And you feel me? Like, they were like, yeah, you should charge that. Yeah, so, shit, I gotta work on my music too. So, if you really want me and really want this feature, like, don't pay them $5. Like, you 250, I need work coming to the studio for.
You would feel comfortable paying $500 to another artist, that local artist that I've seen?
Only person is probably, like, you know, the bigger people. Yeah. But I ain't gonna lie, Samiri worth $5.
Yeah.
I feel like she worth $5.
That local artist.
Yeah.
So since you've been doing it though, you just find somebody that ate you up and then you like, man, I gotta scrap that.
Wait, that's that again?
When you went to the booth and you did a song with somebody.
Yeah.
They eat you up and you like, man, I gotta scrap that shit.
I don't know what you mean by that.
Why? They killed you on the song.
Oh, no. But, oh, I will say, that's why I say Samiri. Like, I feel like, bro, like, I keep mentioning Samiri in my interview, but I really, like, she really hard to me. Like, we went to the studio, we had went to the block not too long ago. We did a little song. We been supposed to drop it. Me and like five other girls. Like, I feel like, oh, Debrina too, y'all. Debrina.
Yeah, yeah. And me, Miracle, T.B, DB, and Shamartis.
Oh, y'all did like a collab.
Yeah.
Is out?
No. Oh. It need to be though. That's only five.
But we had all the songs and shit like that. I'm like, hold on, now let me go. I might have to reconsider my verse. The Breeder, Samir, I'm gonna come home. I'm like, y'all come but I was on the hook anyway, so I wasn't really tripping.
Yeah. She said that too. She said everybody was scared to drop their verse.
Yeah, everybody, me, Miracle, all of them, we scared to drop our verse, but then we hitting each other shit. Like, oh, everybody shit hard. Like, we in here like that.
So when y'all gonna put that out?
I don't know, it's so hard because we did the song and we just had post and went back and just like did ad libs and shit, but he had lost our session or whatever. I guess some shit had happened with him moving and shit like that, so everybody ain't been on the same schedule no more to like go do the song. We tried to go do it separately, but it wasn't really working out. Like, and then we can't get that song back how it first was. You know what I'm saying? So it was like hard.
You think that song is gonna be strong?
Yeah, I really think so.
Over with for that song?
Nah, I don't think it's over with, but like I said, we had did a song to a remix. The song been out for a minute now, so you know when you doing remixes, you really gotta go on. Catch a wild hat.
Alright, we finna go and get ready to wrap it up. Is there anything you wanna tell your fan?
Just thank y'all for supporting me, and we're gonna have a lot of more music on the way, and you feel me, like, we finna really put more wheel on the map.
And where they can find you at on social media?
Y'all can find me at T.B TIARRA on Instagram and T.B TIARRA on Facebook and YouTube T.B TIARRA.
Hold on, one more time. So you martyr too?
Yeah, I do a little bit.
Alright.
I say modeling, I just say like promoting and branding for people like to the side, just to make a little money.
Well, I almost forgot about that. And you said your YouTube and Instagram, what?
T.B TIARRA, everything T.B TIARRA.
Shout out to GM TV before we get out of here.
Shout out to GM TV, y'all.
It's GM TV, getting y'all out of the gym, out of the city.